Manifest abundance in all areas. Introduction: The Infinite Garden. Picture yourself standing in the midst of an expansive, sunlit garden. Its soil is dark and rich, promising nourishment for whatever is planted. The air hums with the soft buzz of bees and the rustling of leaves, alive with the energy of growth. In this garden, every seed planted has the potential to grow into something magnificent. Yet, the yield of the harvest depends entirely on the care given, watering, sunlight, and the removal of weeds. This garden is not just a place. It is a symbol of your life, your mind, and your spirit, each one capable of bearing an abundant harvest when nurtured with intention. The infinite garden represents abundance in all its forms: love, health, wealth, creativity, and fulfillment. It is a reminder that abundance is not confined to material wealth but is a universal principle, woven into the very fabric of existence. Just as the garden requires fertile soil and consistent care, abundance in life arises from cultivating the right conditions in our thoughts, beliefs, and actions. The seeds we plant, our intentions, are the foundation for what we manifest. Abundance is not a distant dream but an innate potential within each of us, waiting to be activated. By aligning your mindset, emotions, and habits with the energy of abundance, you become a co-creator with the universe, capable of manifesting limitless possibilities. Just as the garden responds to the attention it receives, life reflects the energy and care you bring to it. How might you begin to tend your own inner garden, cultivating the conditions that allow abundance to flourish? This book is your guide to understanding and aligning with the principles of abundance. Through symbolic imagery, practical tools, and reflective prompts, it will teach you how to plant, nurture, and harvest abundance in all areas of your life. The infinite garden is already within you, waiting for your touch. Will you choose to step into its fertile soil and begin the journey of manifesting the life you desire? Your garden is ready to bloom. How will you tend it? The infinite garden is a powerful metaphor for abundance, revealing how the conditions we create in our inner world shape the outcomes we experience in life. Just as a garden depends on fertile soil, healthy seeds, and consistent care, our lives flourish when we cultivate a mindset and environment that align with abundance. This garden is not a distant field. It exists within you, waiting to be nurtured and brought to life. At the heart of abundance lies the principle of intention. The seeds we plant in our garden represent the intentions we set, our desires, goals, and aspirations. Intention is the starting point of creation, the spark that sets the wheels of manifestation in motion. However, a seed cannot grow in barren soil. It requires the nourishment of belief, emotion, and focused action. When intention is aligned with these energies, it becomes a powerful force for transformation. How clear are the seeds of intention you've planted, and what might you do to nurture their growth? Abundance is not a one-dimensional concept confined to material wealth. It extends into every area of life. The love you share in relationships, the vitality you feel in your body, the creativity you bring to your work, and the fulfillment you find in moments of joy and peace. Each of these aspects is a different crop in the garden, and each one requires unique care. By viewing abundance holistically, you begin to recognize how interconnected these areas are. The health of one crop influences the yield of another. For example, cultivating gratitude for the love in your life can ripple outward, attracting greater financial opportunities or improving your physical well-being. To create an abundant life, it's essential to prepare the soil of the garden by clearing limiting beliefs and cultivating empowering ones. Limiting beliefs act like weeds, crowding the soil and competing for the nutrients that should nourish your seeds of intention. These beliefs often arise from past experiences, societal conditioning, or fear of failure. They whisper doubts like, "I'm not good enough," or, there's not enough to go around. Left unchecked, they stifle growth and block the flow of abundance. Identifying and uprooting these beliefs is a vital first step in creating fertile ground for your dreams. Clearing the soil requires self-awareness and intentional practice. Tools such as journaling, meditation, and affirmations can help you uncover and release limiting beliefs. For example, writing about recurring fears or doubts allows you to see them clearly, and reframing them into positive affirmations plants new seeds of possibility. What beliefs have been acting as weeds in your garden, and how might you begin to replace them with thoughts that empower and inspire you? Once the soil is prepared, the act of planting becomes an exercise in faith and trust. You cannot force a seed to grow, but you can provide the conditions that allow it to thrive. This requires consistency and patience, a willingness to tend to your intentions with care even when you cannot yet see the results. In the garden, this might mean watering and weeding daily. In life, it might involve showing up for your goals, nurturing your relationships, or practicing self-care. Trusting the process is as important as the actions you take. How might you show up more consistently for the seeds you've planted, and what practices can help you trust in their eventual growth? One of the most transformative energies in the garden of abundance is gratitude. Gratitude acts like sunlight, amplifying the growth of your intentions by shifting your focus to what is already thriving. When you give thanks for the blessings you have, you activate the energy of abundance, drawing more of it into your life. A daily gratitude practice, whether it's listing three things you're thankful for each morning or expressing appreciation to others, can attune your mindset to the infinite possibilities that surround you. What blessings can you celebrate today, and how might cultivating gratitude enhance your connection to abundance? The garden also requires balance. Overwatering or neglecting a single crop can lead to imbalance, just as overemphasis on one area of life can deplete another. Living abundantly means creating harmony between your aspirations and responsibilities, your giving and receiving, your action and rest. This balance is not static. It requires constant adjustment, like pruning branches or rotating crops to ensure the garden remains vibrant. Where in your life might you seek greater balance, and how can you begin to make those adjustments? Finally, the garden of abundance thrives when it is shared. Just as a flourishing garden provides enough to feed many, an abundant life creates overflow, resources, love, joy, that can be shared with others. This sharing does not diminish abundance. It multiplies it, creating a ripple effect that enhances the lives of those around you. How might you use your garden's harvest to uplift and inspire others, ensuring that abundance flows freely and continuously? The infinite garden is not a metaphor of arrival but a process of becoming. Its lessons remind us that abundance is not a fixed state but a dynamic relationship with life. By tending to your intentions, nurturing your beliefs, and trusting in the process, you align yourself with the universal flow of abundance. What steps will you take to cultivate your inner garden, and how might its harvest transform not only your life but the lives of those around you? The soil is ready, the seeds are waiting. How will you begin to nurture the garden of your soul? As you reflect on the infinite garden within you, consider the seeds you have planted and the care you are giving them. Are your intentions clear and purposeful, or do they need more focus and nurturing? What steps can you take to cultivate the conditions that allow them to thrive? The garden reminds us that growth is a process, one that requires both patience and consistent effort. Take a moment to visualize your inner garden. Picture its soil rich and fertile, its plants thriving under the warm glow of sunlight. Imagine yourself pulling out the weeds of limiting beliefs, clearing space for new growth. Feel the joy of watering your intentions with love, faith, and gratitude, trusting that your efforts will bear fruit in their perfect season. What does this garden reveal about your current state of mind, and how might you tend to it more intentionally? The infinite garden is a reflection of your capacity to create, to transform, and to align with the energy of abundance. By nurturing this garden, you are not only cultivating a more abundant life for yourself but also creating a ripple effect that touches the lives of others. What harvest are you preparing to share, and how might your garden's bounty inspire and uplift those around you? Your garden is alive with potential, its soil waiting for your touch, its seeds eager to grow. How will you nurture this sacred space, ensuring that it remains a source of beauty, fulfillment, and abundance? The garden is infinite, its possibilities limitless. Are you ready to step into its flow and let its vitality shape your journey? Your hands hold the tools, your heart holds the vision. How will you bring this garden to life? Before we start, if you're here to grow and tap into something deeper, like and subscribe. Your support helps us awaken other minds and continue sharing these insights with those seeking transformation. Thank you for being a part of this journey. Chapter 1. The Seed of Intention. Imagine holding a seed in your palm, small and unassuming. To the untrained eye, it appears as nothing more than a speck of life. Yet, within its tiny shell lies infinite potential, a towering tree, a fragrant flower, or even an entire forest. This seed carries the blueprint of its future, but it depends on your care to bring it to life. Will you plant it in fertile soil, nurture it with water and sunlight, and protect it from harm? Or will it remain dormant, its potential unrealized? The seed represents intention, the starting point of all creation. Every great achievement, every transformation, begins as a single thought, a desire to bring something new into existence. Intention is not passive. It is a force of focused energy, a spark that ignites the journey of manifestation. Just as the seed holds within it the possibility of growth, your intentions contain the power to shape your reality. In this chapter, we will explore the profound role of intention in manifesting abundance. How do your thoughts, beliefs, and emotions influence the seeds you plant? What can you do to align your intentions with the outcomes you desire? The journey of abundance begins with understanding and harnessing the power of intention. Let us step into this fertile space, ready to plant the seeds that will shape your future. Intention is the seed from which all creation grows. It is the starting point of every endeavor, the spark that sets the process of manifestation in motion. Just as a seed holds within it the potential for a thriving tree or a radiant flower, your intentions contain the blueprint of the reality you wish to create. However, the journey from seed to fruition requires alignment, care, and action. Without nurturing, even the most potent intention remains dormant, its potential unrealized. The first step in working with the power of intention is clarity. Just as a gardener selects seeds based on the harvest they desire, you must identify what you truly want to manifest. Vague or conflicting intentions are like scattering seeds without aim. Some may take root, but others will wither without focus. A clear intention acts as a beacon, directing your energy and actions toward a specific outcome. What do you truly desire, and how clearly have you defined it in your mind? Clarity is not just about defining the goal. It's about aligning your intention with your deeper values and aspirations. Intentions that stem from fear, doubt, or external pressure are like seeds planted in rocky soil. They struggle to grow. In contrast, intentions grounded in authenticity and love resonate with the flow of abundance, creating fertile ground for growth. Reflect on your current intentions. Are they aligned with your highest self, or are they influenced by fear or societal expectations? Once clarity is achieved, the next step is aligning your energy with your intention. The seed cannot grow in barren soil, just as your intention cannot manifest without the right mindset and emotions. Your thoughts and beliefs act as the soil in which your intentions are planted. Negative self-talk, limiting beliefs, or unresolved fears are like weeds that compete with the seed for nutrients. To nurture your intention, you must cultivate a positive and empowering mental environment. What beliefs or thoughts might be hindering your intentions, and how can you begin to replace them with affirming ones? Emotions are the water that nourishes the seed, infusing it with life and energy. Intentions set with joy, excitement, and gratitude are far more powerful than those accompanied by doubt or anxiety. This emotional alignment creates a magnetic force, attracting opportunities, resources, and connections that support your intention. How do you feel when you think about your goals? Are your emotions supporting their growth, or are they creating resistance? Action is the sunlight that helps the seed grow. No matter how clear or aligned your intention is, it cannot manifest without tangible steps. Action bridges the gap between the inner world of intention and the outer world of manifestation. These steps do not need to be grand. Even small, consistent actions signal to the universe that you are committed to your vision. Imagine a gardener watering a seedling every day, trusting that these small efforts will eventually lead to a lush harvest. What actions can you take today to nurture your intention? Another vital element in nurturing the seed of intention is patience. Just as seeds germinate in their own time, intentions manifest in alignment with universal timing. Impatience or doubt can lead to overwatering, pulling up the roots to check for progress, or abandoning the process altogether. Trust is essential. Trust in your effort, trust in the process, and trust in the abundance of the universe. How can you cultivate greater patience and faith in your journey? The energy of gratitude is one of the most powerful forces in nurturing intention. Gratitude is like sunlight that encourages the seed to grow, amplifying its potential. By expressing thanks for what you already have, you shift your focus to abundance, creating fertile ground for more to flow into your life. Gratitude is not only a response to outcomes, it is an active practice that reinforces the energy of intention. What are you grateful for today, and how might this energy enhance your connection to your goals? It is also essential to protect the seed from external influences that could hinder its growth. Just as a gardener shields seedlings from harsh weather or pests, you must safeguard your intentions from negativity, distractions, and doubt. Surround yourself with supportive people, environments, and practices that nurture your focus and energy. What boundaries or changes might help you protect the seeds of your intentions? The seed of intention is a reminder of your innate ability to create, to transform, and to align with the flow of abundance. It holds infinite potential, but its growth depends on your willingness to nurture it with clarity, emotion, action, and trust. Every seed you plant is an opportunity to shape your reality, to align with your deepest desires, and to manifest a life of purpose and fulfillment. What intentions are you planting in your garden of life, and how are you nurturing their growth? What steps can you take today to align your thoughts, emotions, and actions with your vision? The seed is small but mighty, holding within it the power to transform your world. How will you tend to it and trust in its eventual bloom? The process has already begun. How will you continue to care for the seeds you've sown? As you hold the image of the seed in your mind, consider the intentions you are planting in your life right now. Are these seeds chosen with care and clarity, or are they scattered without focus? What steps might you take to nurture them, ensuring they have the conditions needed to grow into their fullest potential? Every intention you plant is a reflection of your inner desires and dreams, a commitment to creating something meaningful. Imagine your inner garden, its soil rich and fertile, waiting to receive the seeds of your intention. See yourself planting these seeds with love and purpose, watering them with positive emotions and nourishing them with consistent action. How does this vision inspire you to engage more fully with the process of manifestation? The seed also teaches us patience and trust. Growth cannot be forced, and the fruits of your labor may not be immediately visible. Yet, beneath the surface, the seed is transforming, its roots spreading, its stem preparing to emerge. Trust in this unseen progress, and commit to nurturing your intentions with faith and gratitude. What practices can help you remain patient and aligned as you await the harvest of your intentions? The journey of manifesting abundance begins with a single seed, a small yet powerful act of creation. What seeds will you plant today, and how will you tend to them in the days and weeks ahead? The garden of your life is fertile and ready, the seed full of potential. How will you nurture it to ensure it grows into the reality you envision? The harvest is on the horizon. How will you prepare for its arrival? Chapter 2. Clearing the soil, releasing limiting beliefs. Imagine a neglected garden patch, overrun with weeds. These weeds tangle around the soil, choking out the light and space needed for new seeds to grow. Beneath the surface, their roots intertwine, stealing nutrients and leaving the soil depleted. Yet, with care and effort, the soil can be cleared. As the weeds are pulled away, the earth begins to breathe again, opening itself to new possibilities and fresh growth. This image mirrors the landscape of the mind, where limiting beliefs act like weeds, crowding out the potential for abundance and growth. These beliefs, often unexamined, create invisible barriers that block the flow of opportunity, love, and prosperity. Just as a gardener must identify and remove weeds to prepare the soil, you must uncover and release these limiting beliefs to create fertile ground for your intentions to thrive. In this chapter, we will explore the process of identifying and uprooting the beliefs that hinder your ability to manifest abundance. What fears or doubts have taken root in your mind, and how can you clear them away to make space for growth? The soil of your inner garden is ready to be renewed. Are you prepared to begin the work of transformation? Just as weeds in a garden compete with flourishing plants, limiting beliefs in the mind hinder the growth of your intentions. These beliefs are often deeply rooted, formed by past experiences, cultural conditioning, or internalized fears. They whisper doubts, create resistance, and prevent the seeds of abundance from taking root. Clearing the soil of these beliefs is essential for creating a fertile ground where your intentions can thrive. Limiting beliefs often operate in the background, influencing your thoughts and actions without conscious awareness. To clear them, the first step is identification. Begin by examining the patterns in your life that feel stuck or resistant. Are there recurring challenges in your relationships, finances, or sense of self-worth? These patterns often point to underlying beliefs that need to be uncovered. For example, a struggle with financial stability may be rooted in the belief that money is scarce or that wealth is unattainable. What recurring patterns in your life might be rooted in limiting beliefs? Journaling can be a powerful tool for bringing these beliefs to light. Set aside time to write freely about areas of your life where you feel blocked. Ask yourself, what fears or doubts come up when I think about abundance? What messages about success, love, or worthiness did I internalize from my past? As you write, you may notice themes or phrases that reveal the core beliefs shaping your experiences. These insights are the first steps toward transformation. What truths have you uncovered about the beliefs shaping your current reality? Once a limiting belief is identified, the next step is to question its validity. Limiting beliefs often thrive because they are accepted as truth without challenge. However, when examined, they frequently reveal themselves as assumptions rather than facts. For instance, the belief, "I'm not good enough," may stem from a single failure or critical comment, yet it is applied broadly to multiple areas of life. By questioning these beliefs, asking where they came from, whether they are true, and whether they serve you, you begin to loosen their hold. How might challenging your limiting beliefs shift your perspective and open new possibilities? Reframing is a key technique for replacing limiting beliefs with empowering ones. This process involves consciously choosing a new belief that aligns with abundance and possibility. For example, the belief, "I'll never succeed," can be reframed as, "I am capable of learning and growing with every step." Affirmations can help reinforce these new beliefs, creating a mental environment that supports growth. What affirmations resonate with your vision of abundance, and how can you incorporate them into your daily practice? Clearing limiting beliefs also requires addressing the emotions tied to them. Fear, guilt, and shame often accompany these beliefs, creating a cycle of self-doubt that reinforces their power. To release these emotions, consider practices such as meditation, breathwork, or visualization. Imagine yourself pulling the weeds of doubt from your mental garden, releasing their hold and replacing them with light and nourishment. What practices can help you release the emotions that keep limiting beliefs in place? It's important to recognize that clearing limiting beliefs is not a one-time event but an ongoing process. Just as weeds can return to a garden, old beliefs may resurface during times of stress or change. By cultivating awareness and regularly tending to your inner landscape, you can prevent these beliefs from taking root again. This practice requires consistency, compassion, and a willingness to face the truths within yourself. How can you commit to the continual process of clearing and nurturing your mental garden? Surrounding yourself with supportive environments and influences also plays a vital role in maintaining clear soil. Negative or critical environments can reinforce limiting beliefs, while uplifting and affirming spaces help new beliefs take root. Seek out relationships, communities, and practices that align with your vision of abundance. These connections act as sunlight, helping your intentions grow strong and resilient. Who or what in your life can provide the encouragement and support you need as you transform your beliefs? The process of clearing limiting beliefs is both challenging and liberating. It requires facing uncomfortable truths, letting go of familiar patterns, and stepping into the unknown. Yet, as the soil is cleared, the potential for growth becomes limitless. With every weed you remove, you make space for new possibilities, greater abundance, and deeper alignment with your true self. What might your life look like with the soil cleared, the weeds removed, and the seeds of your intentions flourishing? The garden of your mind is ready to be renewed. By uncovering and releasing the beliefs that no longer serve you, you create a foundation for abundance to flow freely. The soil is rich with potential, waiting for your touch. What beliefs are you ready to release, and what new truths will you plant in their place? The transformation begins here. How will you clear the soil and prepare for the growth ahead? As you reflect on the garden of your mind, consider the beliefs that have shaped your experiences. Which ones act as weeds, tangling your thoughts and blocking the flow of abundance? What patterns or fears have you carried, and how might releasing them create space for new growth? Picture yourself standing in your inner garden, your hands firmly grasping the roots of a persistent weed. With intention and effort, you pull it from the soil, watching as its hold releases. Feel the lightness of the earth beneath your fingers, ready now to nourish the seeds of your intentions. What does it feel like to create this space, to make room for the possibilities that await? The process of clearing limiting beliefs is a gift to yourself, a commitment to align with your potential, to honor your dreams, and to nurture the conditions for your growth. What beliefs are you ready to let go of, and what empowering truths will you replace them with? The soil of your inner garden is prepared, fertile and open to the seeds you will plant. How will you tend to it with love and care? Your garden is a reflection of your willingness to transform, to step beyond the old and embrace the new. As you clear the soil, you prepare not only for abundance but for alignment with your highest self. What new truths are taking root within you, and how will they shape the path ahead? The soil is clear, the space is open. How will you begin anew in the garden of your mind? Chapter 3. The Energy of Gratitude. Picture a golden chalice, gleaming in the sunlight, overflowing with crystal clear water. The water cascades over the rim, spilling into a pool that ripples outward, creating waves of beauty and abundance. This chalice is not diminished by its overflow. Instead, it grows brighter, its presence more radiant with each wave it creates. This is the energy of gratitude, a force that multiplies blessings and magnifies the flow of abundance in your life. Gratitude is more than an emotion. It is a state of being, a practice that aligns you with the energy of abundance. Like sunlight nourishing a plant or water quenching its roots, gratitude feeds the intentions you've planted, amplifying their growth. It shifts your focus from lack to sufficiency, from what you fear to what you celebrate. It is the bridge between your current reality and the one you aspire to create. In this chapter, we will explore the transformative power of gratitude and its role in manifesting abundance. How can you cultivate a mindset of appreciation, even when faced with challenges? What practices will attune you to the blessings already present in your life? The golden chalice is already overflowing. Are you ready to let its energy guide you toward infinite abundance? Gratitude is often thought of as a simple act of saying, "Thank you," but its energy reaches far deeper. It is a profound state of alignment, a practice that connects you to the abundance already present in your life while opening the door to receive even more. Gratitude is the golden chalice overflowing, reminding you that blessings are not finite but expansive, growing brighter and more abundant the more you acknowledge them. At its core, gratitude is a shift in focus. The human mind is naturally inclined to seek out problems, a survival instinct that kept early humans alert to danger. Yet this tendency can leave us blind to the blessings around us, focusing on lack instead of sufficiency. Gratitude disrupts this pattern, inviting you to redirect your attention from what is missing to what is present. What in your life might you be overlooking, and how might recognizing it transform your perspective? Gratitude also acts as an amplifier, magnifying the energy of abundance. By expressing appreciation for what you already have, you signal to the universe and to your subconscious mind that you are attuned to abundance. This practice not only enhances your awareness of existing blessings but also attracts more of them into your life. The principle is simple. Where attention goes, energy flows. What would happen if you shifted your attention to the gifts already present, no matter how small? Practically, cultivating gratitude begins with awareness. Start by noticing the moments in your day that bring you joy, comfort, or connection. It might be the warmth of the morning sun, the laughter of a friend, or the satisfaction of completing a task. These moments, when acknowledged, become seeds of gratitude that grow with your attention. How might a simple shift in awareness change the way you perceive your daily life? One of the most effective tools for practicing gratitude is a daily gratitude journal. Each day, write down three things you are grateful for. They can be as grand as a significant achievement or as simple as a good cup of coffee. The act of writing reinforces the habit, helping you cultivate a mindset of appreciation. Over time, this practice rewires your brain to seek out positivity, creating a foundation for greater abundance. What might you include in your gratitude journal today, and how would this practice shape your week? Gratitude is not limited to the good times. It becomes even more powerful when practiced during challenges. Life is rarely without difficulties, yet gratitude invites you to find the silver linings, the lessons, and the growth within these moments. For instance, a setback at work might teach resilience, or a difficult conversation might strengthen a relationship. By finding something to appreciate even in adversity, you shift from resistance to acceptance, creating space for growth. What challenges in your life might hold hidden blessings, and how could gratitude help you uncover them? Gratitude also strengthens your relationships by fostering connection and appreciation. Expressing thanks to others not only deepens your bonds but also reinforces the flow of abundance between you. A heartfelt thank you can transform an interaction, creating a ripple effect of positivity. Who in your life deserves your gratitude today, and how might expressing it strengthen your connection? The energy of gratitude extends beyond words. It is a way of being. When you approach life with a grateful heart, you exude a sense of peace and abundance that others can feel. This energy attracts opportunities, deepens connections, and inspires those around you. Gratitude is contagious, spreading like sunlight across the garden of your life, nourishing everything it touches. How might embodying gratitude in your actions inspire those around you to do the same? Visualization is another powerful way to connect with the energy of gratitude. Close your eyes and imagine the golden chalice overflowing with blessings. Picture each drop of water as something you are grateful for. Your health, your family, your talents, your dreams. Feel the warmth of the chalice in your hands, its glow spreading through your body. As the water overflows, see it nourishing the soil of your intentions, helping them grow strong and vibrant. How does this visualization shift your perspective and attune you to the abundance around you? Gratitude is not a passive state. It is an active practice that aligns you with the flow of abundance. It transforms your mindset, rewires your brain, and amplifies the blessings in your life. It is the sunlight that nourishes your garden, the water that quenches its thirst, the energy that keeps it thriving. When you cultivate gratitude, you step into a higher frequency, one that attracts more joy, love, and prosperity into your life. How can you deepen your gratitude practice, making it a cornerstone of your journey toward abundance? The golden chalice of gratitude is already overflowing, its water spilling out to touch every corner of your life. Will you take it in your hands, let it nourish your intentions, and allow its energy to guide you? The more you embrace gratitude, the more it will transform your life, opening pathways to growth, connection, and fulfillment. What blessings are you ready to celebrate today, and how will you let gratitude shape your tomorrow? The chalice is in your grasp. How will you let its energy flow through you? As you hold the image of the golden chalice in your mind, consider the blessings that are already overflowing in your life. What moments, people, or experiences bring light to your days? How have they nourished your spirit and shaped your journey? Let this gratitude ripple outward, like waves spreading from a drop of water in a still pond, touching every corner of your existence. Gratitude is the bridge between where you are and where you want to be. It reminds you that abundance is not a distant dream but a present reality waiting to be acknowledged. By embracing gratitude, you amplify its energy, creating space for even greater blessings to flow into your life. What specific practices will you adopt to keep this energy alive, nurturing your connection to abundance? The golden chalice is not just a symbol. It is a reflection of your capacity to see and celebrate the good in your life. Imagine holding it now, its warmth and light radiating through your hands. Each drop that spills over is an affirmation of the abundance already present. How will you carry this chalice forward, allowing its overflow to inspire your actions and uplift those around you? Gratitude is your ally, your guide, your source of strength. What will you celebrate today, and how will this practice shape your tomorrow? The chalice overflows. How will you let its energy transform your life and the lives of those you touch? The energy of gratitude is limitless. How will you let it flow? Chapter 4. Opening the channels of receiving. Picture a river winding through a lush valley, its waters clear and abundant, flowing effortlessly toward the horizon. The river does not question its path. It simply moves, its flow unhindered, nourishing the land it touches. Now imagine a dam built across the river, its walls halting the flow. The water pools behind it, its energy stagnant, unable to reach the fertile fields beyond. This image reflects the energy of receiving. Just as the river's flow sustains the valley, abundance flows into our lives through open channels. But when we resist receiving, whether through feelings of unworthiness, guilt, or fear, we create dams that block the flow, leaving us disconnected from the very abundance we seek. In this chapter, we will explore the art of opening the channels of receiving. How can you identify and remove the blocks that hinder abundance from flowing into your life? What practices will help you create an open and receptive mindset? The river of abundance is always flowing. Are you ready to let it nourish your life and your dreams? The river of abundance flows endlessly, yet its ability to reach you depends on your openness to receiving. Receiving is not a passive state. It is an active alignment, a willingness to embrace the flow of opportunities, love, and prosperity that the universe offers. However, many of us unintentionally build dams in this river, blocking the natural flow and creating stagnation. These blocks are often rooted in limiting beliefs, emotional resistance, or a lack of trust in the abundance available to us. To open the channels of receiving, we must first understand what it means to allow abundance into our lives. At its core, receiving is an act of worthiness. It is a declaration that you are deserving of the blessings and opportunities that come your way. Yet, feelings of unworthiness are one of the most common barriers to receiving. Messages from childhood, societal conditioning, or past failures can plant the belief that you must earn abundance or that you are not enough. These beliefs act like a dam, halting the flow of abundance before it can reach you. Reflect on your relationship with worthiness. Do you feel you need to achieve or prove something to deserve what you desire? How might embracing your inherent worthiness change the way you approach receiving? Another block to receiving is the fear of judgment. Accepting help, opportunities, or gifts can sometimes feel vulnerable, as if it exposes a weakness or a need. This fear can manifest as rejecting compliments, refusing assistance, or downplaying achievements. Yet, the act of receiving is not about weakness, it is about connection and flow. When you allow yourself to receive, you create a balance between giving and taking, a dynamic exchange that sustains relationships and opens new possibilities. What fears of judgment might be holding you back, and how can you reframe receiving as a strength rather than a vulnerability? Guilt is another common barrier to receiving. This often arises from the belief that abundance is finite, that accepting more for yourself takes away from others. However, abundance is not a zero-sum game. The universe operates on principles of expansion, not limitation, and your ability to receive enhances your ability to give. Imagine a vessel filling with water. As it overflows, it nourishes everything around it. How might releasing guilt allow you to receive more freely and share more generously? To open the channels of receiving, it's essential to cultivate a mindset of trust. Trust that the universe is abundant, that what flows to you is meant for you, and that receiving does not diminish others but contributes to the collective flow. This trust requires letting go of control, surrendering the need to micromanage how and when abundance arrives. Consider the river. It does not demand that the rain fall at a specific time or place. It simply flows, trusting the natural cycles. Where in your life can you practice greater trust, allowing abundance to flow without resistance? Practical steps can help reinforce this trust and openness. One such practice is affirmations that align your mindset with the energy of receiving. Phrases like, "I am open to receiving all the good the universe has to offer," or "I am worthy of love, abundance, and joy," help reprogram the subconscious mind, replacing old patterns with new possibilities. Repeating these affirmations regularly can create a shift in your energy, inviting more flow into your life. What affirmations resonate with your current journey, and how can you integrate them into your daily practice? Gratitude also plays a vital role in opening the channels of receiving. By expressing appreciation for what you already have, you reinforce the energy of abundance and create space for more to flow. Gratitude shifts your focus from lack to sufficiency, from fear to trust. Imagine receiving a gift and expressing heartfelt thanks. This gratitude not only honors the giver but also invites more blessings into your life. How might practicing gratitude for the small and large things in your life enhance your ability to receive? Visualization is another powerful tool for opening the channels of receiving. Close your eyes and picture a river flowing freely, its waters clear and abundant. See yourself as part of this river, its energy moving through you without resistance. Imagine any blocks, doubts, fears, or guilt melting away, allowing the flow to reach every part of your life. Feel the openness in your heart, the readiness to accept and embrace all that is offered. How does this visualization shift your energy and mindset? Finally, practice receiving in small, everyday ways. Accept compliments graciously instead of deflecting them. Allow others to help you without feeling the need to reciprocate immediately. Say yes to opportunities, even if they stretch your comfort zone. Each of these acts reinforces your openness, creating a habit of receiving that extends to every area of your life. What small steps can you take today to practice the art of receiving more fully? The river of abundance is always flowing, ready to nourish your life with its gifts. By removing the blocks that hinder its flow, you create space for opportunities, love, and prosperity to reach you. Receiving is not about taking. It is about participating in the natural exchange of energy, aligning yourself with the rhythm of giving and receiving. What blocks are you ready to release, and how will you let the flow of abundance move freely through your life? The river is waiting. How will you open the channels and step into its current? Take a moment to visualize the river of abundance, its waters flowing freely, carrying with it opportunities, love, and prosperity. As you stand by its edge, what blocks do you notice within yourself? Feelings of unworthiness, guilt, or fear of judgment that might be halting the flow? How can you begin to release these barriers, opening your heart and mind to receive all that the universe has to offer? Imagine the flow of the river reaching every part of your life, nourishing your intentions and creating space for new possibilities. See the dam within you dissolving, its walls crumbling as the water rushes forward, filling the empty spaces. How does this image reflect the changes you wish to make in your relationship with receiving? Receiving is a powerful act of alignment, a recognition that you are worthy of abundance in all its forms. What steps can you take today to affirm this worthiness and welcome the gifts that come your way? The river is always flowing, its energy endless and generous. Are you ready to open the channels, to let its current carry you toward the life you envision? The flow is already moving. How will you embrace it? If this audiobook is sparking new insights for you, show some love by hitting like and subscribing. Let me know in the comments what resonates with you the most so far. I'd love to hear your thoughts as we go deeper. Chapter 5. The Resonance of Abundance. Imagine a tuning fork struck softly, its vibrations filling the air with a clear, harmonious tone. As it resonates, nearby objects begin to vibrate in response, aligning with its frequency. This phenomenon reflects a universal truth: like attracts like. When you tune into a frequency of abundance, the energy of the world around you begins to match your vibration, amplifying your ability to manifest your desires. Your thoughts, emotions, and actions emit their own frequency, shaping the energy you attract into your life. Abundance is not something external to chase, it is a vibration to embody. To resonate with abundance is to align every part of your being with the energy of possibility, joy, and gratitude, creating a magnetic force that draws blessings toward you. In this chapter, we will explore the resonance of abundance and how to attune yourself to its frequency. What thoughts or feelings might be out of tune with the energy you wish to cultivate? How can you shift your vibration to harmonize with the flow of abundance? The tuning fork is already vibrating. Are you ready to align yourself with its song? The resonance of abundance is a natural state, one in which your thoughts, emotions, and actions align with the energy of prosperity, joy, and fulfillment. Like the tuning fork, this resonance attracts experiences, opportunities, and relationships that match your vibration. To resonate with abundance is to live in harmony with the universal flow, drawing to you the circumstances that reflect your inner state. But how do you ensure that your energy aligns with the frequency of abundance, and how can you maintain this alignment even amid life's challenges? The first step is awareness. Just as a musician listens carefully to ensure their instrument is in tune, you must listen to the vibrations of your thoughts and emotions. Are they in harmony with abundance, or are they dissonant? Thoughts of scarcity, fear, or self-doubt emit a low frequency, creating a resonance that attracts lack or struggle. In contrast, thoughts of gratitude, possibility, and trust raise your vibration, aligning you with the flow of abundance. What are the dominant thoughts and feelings in your daily life, and how do they influence your vibration? Shifting your vibration begins with intention. Just as a tuning fork must be struck to emit its tone, your energy requires activation. Setting a clear intention for abundance is like choosing a musical note to resonate with. It focuses your energy and directs your actions. For example, affirming, "I align with the energy of abundance and welcome its flow into my life," is a simple yet powerful way to tune yourself to this frequency. How might setting a daily intention create a foundation for your resonance with abundance? Emotions play a central role in shaping your vibration. Joy, gratitude, and love are high-frequency emotions that naturally align with abundance, while fear, frustration, and resentment lower your vibration. To raise your emotional frequency, cultivate practices that generate positive emotions. Gratitude journaling, visualization, or engaging in activities that bring you joy are simple yet effective ways to elevate your energy. Imagine the tuning fork of your heart vibrating with joy. How does this image inspire you to cultivate higher frequency emotions? Visualization is another powerful tool for aligning with abundance. Close your eyes and picture your life resonating with the energy of prosperity and joy. See yourself surrounded by opportunities, your intentions manifesting effortlessly, your relationships flourishing. Feel the emotions that accompany this vision: gratitude, excitement, peace, and let them fill your body. This practice not only attunes your vibration but also trains your subconscious mind to seek out and act on opportunities that align with abundance. What specific visions inspire you, and how can you make visualization a regular part of your practice? Your actions must also align with the energy of abundance. Acting from a place of scarcity, hoarding resources, avoiding risks, or focusing solely on immediate needs sends a signal of lack to the universe. In contrast, acting with trust and generosity reinforces the frequency of abundance. This doesn't mean being reckless. It means taking inspired actions that reflect your belief in the flow of prosperity. How might your actions shift if you trusted that abundance is always available to you? Raising your vibration also requires you to release what no longer serves you. Negative self-talk, toxic relationships, and environments that drain your energy act as static, disrupting your resonance with abundance. Letting go of these influences clears the way for higher frequencies to flow. What in your life feels out of tune with the energy of abundance, and how can you begin to release it? Surrounding yourself with high vibration influences can amplify your resonance. Just as two tuning forks placed near each other will vibrate in harmony, Being around people, environments, and practices that reflect abundance helps elevate your own frequency. Seek out supportive relationships, inspiring spaces, and uplifting content that reinforce your alignment. Who or what in your life resonates with abundance, and how can you connect with these influences more often? The resonance of abundance is not about perfection or constant positivity. Life's challenges and uncertainties may occasionally lower your vibration, and that is natural. The key is to return to alignment, using the tools and practices that resonate most with you. Like tuning an instrument, this process requires patience, consistency, and awareness. How can you develop a practice of realignment, ensuring that your energy remains in harmony with abundance? Finally, remember that resonance is a two-way flow. Just as you attract abundance by raising your vibration, you also contribute to the collective energy of the world. Acts of kindness, generosity, and compassion amplify the frequency of abundance for everyone, creating a ripple effect that benefits the whole. How might your resonance with abundance inspire and uplift others, contributing to the greater flow? Aligning with the resonance of abundance is both an inner and outer journey. It begins with tuning your thoughts, emotions, and actions to the frequency of prosperity and joy, and it extends to the ways you interact with the world around you. What shifts can you make today to raise your vibration, and how will these changes shape the energy you attract? The tuning fork is vibrating, the frequency is clear. Are you ready to align with its song and let abundance flow through every aspect of your life? The harmony is waiting. How will you embrace it? As you reflect on the resonance of abundance, consider the frequency you are currently broadcasting. Are your thoughts and emotions aligned with the energy of prosperity, or do they carry the static of doubt, fear, or scarcity? What steps can you take to tune your vibration, creating a clearer and more harmonious connection to abundance? Imagine the tuning fork vibrating within you, its tone pure and steady, filling your being with the frequency of joy, gratitude, and trust. Feel how this resonance reaches out, touching the world around you, drawing in opportunities, love, and fulfillment. How does this image reflect the alignment you wish to create in your life, and what practices will help you sustain this harmony? The resonance of abundance is a continuous process, a dance between your inner world and the energy you attract. What shifts will you make today to raise your vibration, and how will these changes ripple outward, influencing your experiences and relationships? The harmony of abundance is already within you. How will you let it guide your actions, your thoughts, and your dreams? The song is playing. How will you join its rhythm? Chapter 6. Trusting the timing of growth. Imagine a tiny sapling emerging from the soil, its tender green leaves reaching for the sun. It grows slowly but steadily, its roots spreading deep into the earth, anchoring it against the winds and storms to come. The sapling does not rush its growth, nor does it doubt the process. It trusts the rhythms of the seasons, the warmth of spring, the rains of summer, the rest of winter, knowing that each phase is necessary for its eventual strength and flourishing. This image captures the essence of trusting the timing of growth. Abundance, like the sapling, unfolds in its own time, guided by forces larger than our immediate desires. Yet, in our fast-paced world, impatience often takes hold. We want results now, forgetting that growth requires seasons of preparation, nourishment, and rest. When we try to force outcomes or control the process, we disrupt the natural flow, much like uprooting a plant to check its roots. In this chapter, we will explore the importance of patience and trust in the journey of abundance. How can you surrender to the divine timing of your growth while remaining committed to your intentions? What practices can help you find peace in the waiting? The sapling grows with quiet confidence. Are you ready to embrace its wisdom and trust the timing of your life? The journey of abundance is not one of immediate gratification but of alignment with the natural rhythms of growth. Just as the sapling grows steadily, guided by the seasons and nourished by the soil, your intentions manifest according to a divine timing that often lies beyond your control. Trusting this timing requires patience, faith, and a willingness to let go of the illusion of control. It invites you to surrender to the flow, knowing that every stage of the journey, no matter how slow or challenging, is part of a greater process of unfolding. At the heart of impatience is the fear of uncertainty. When results don't arrive as quickly as we hope, it's easy to feel frustrated or doubt whether our efforts are worthwhile. Yet, just as a farmer knows the harvest cannot be rushed, you must recognize that abundance manifests in its own perfect time. What fears or doubts arise for you when progress feels slow, and how might embracing trust alleviate these emotions? Surrendering to divine timing does not mean passivity or inaction. It means staying present, continuing to nurture your intentions, and allowing the process to unfold without forcing outcomes. Consider the gardener who waters and tends to the soil daily, trusting that growth is happening beneath the surface even when it cannot be seen. Your actions are the nourishment that supports your growth, but the timing of the bloom is not yours to dictate. How can you stay committed to your intentions while releasing the need for immediate results? Patience is a key quality in trusting the timing of growth. It is not simply waiting but actively cultivating a mindset of presence and acceptance. Patience allows you to find joy in the process rather than fixating solely on the outcome. Imagine the sapling that takes years to become a tree. Each day, it grows a little taller, its roots a little stronger, its branches reaching closer to the sky. How might you find fulfillment in the small, incremental steps of your journey, rather than focusing solely on the destination? Faith is another essential component of trusting divine timing. Faith is the belief that what is meant for you will arrive at the right time and in the right way. This faith requires releasing control and embracing the unknown, trusting that the universe is working in your favor even when you cannot see the full picture. Reflect on times in your life when delays or challenges eventually led to outcomes greater than you imagined. How might these experiences reinforce your faith in the timing of abundance? To cultivate trust in divine timing, mindfulness is a powerful practice. By staying present, you anchor yourself in the current moment rather than becoming lost in anxiety about the future. Mindfulness invites you to appreciate what is unfolding here and now, recognizing that each step is part of the journey. Consider a mindfulness practice such as meditation, journaling, or simply taking a walk in nature. How might these practices help you stay grounded and aligned with the flow of abundance? Gratitude also plays a central role in trusting the timing of growth. When you express gratitude for the progress you've made and the blessings already in your life, you shift your focus from lack to sufficiency. Gratitude reminds you that abundance is not only about what is coming but also about what already exists. Imagine standing before the sapling, appreciating its small but significant growth. How can you cultivate gratitude for the stages of growth you are currently experiencing? Divine timing often involves waiting, and waiting can feel uncomfortable or even painful. Yet, waiting is not a void. It is a fertile space where transformation takes place beneath the surface. Consider the caterpillar in its cocoon, seemingly still but undergoing profound change that will enable it to emerge as a butterfly. What transformations might be happening within you during periods of waiting, and how can you honor this hidden growth? Releasing the need to control outcomes is a profound act of trust. When you let go of the how and when of your intentions, you create space for the universe to work in ways you might not expect. This surrender often leads to serendipity, unexpected opportunities, connections, and blessings that align perfectly with your desires. How might letting go of rigid expectations open the door to unexpected abundance? Finally, Trusting the timing of growth requires you to embrace the bigger picture. Life is not a series of isolated events, but an interconnected journey where each experience contributes to your evolution. The delays, challenges, and detours you encounter are not obstacles but opportunities to build resilience, gain clarity, and align more deeply with your purpose. How might reframing these experiences as essential parts of your journey change the way you approach them? Surrendering to divine timing is not about abandoning your dreams but about aligning with the natural flow of creation. It is about recognizing that growth is a process, one that unfolds in its own perfect rhythm. What steps can you take to cultivate patience, trust, and faith in the timing of your life? The sapling grows slowly but steadily, its roots anchoring it, its branches reaching. How will you embody this wisdom, allowing your intentions to flourish in their season? The timing is always right. Are you ready to trust it? As you reflect on the image of the sapling, consider how its steady growth mirrors your own journey. Where in your life are you feeling impatient, yearning for faster progress or immediate results? What might shift if you chose to trust in the natural timing of your growth, knowing that every phase has its purpose? Imagine the roots of the sapling spreading deep into the soil, unseen but essential for its strength and stability. What roots are you cultivating in this moment, and how are they preparing you for the abundance to come? How might trusting this unseen progress bring you peace and confidence in the unfolding of your journey? Divine timing asks you to surrender the need to control, to release the doubts and fears that arise in the waiting. What practices or perspectives will help you stay aligned with faith and patience? How can you find joy in the process, appreciating the small steps and hidden transformations that are already taking place? The sapling does not question the sun, the rain, or the seasons. It trusts the flow of life. What will it mean for you to embrace this wisdom, to trust the timing of your growth and the abundance that awaits? The season of your bloom is coming. How will you prepare your heart and mind to welcome it? Chapter 7. Financial Prosperity. Picture a treasure chest brimming with gold coins, jewels, and rare artifacts, its lid slightly ajar to reveal its glittering contents. This chest is not hidden away in a distant cave or guarded by a mythical creature. It resides within you, waiting to be unlocked. It represents the limitless potential for financial abundance, a resource that grows not through hoarding but through wise stewardship and flow. Financial prosperity is often viewed as an external goal, something to be pursued and attained. Yet, true wealth begins as an inner state, shaped by your beliefs, mindset, and relationship with money. Like the treasure chest, financial prosperity is a reflection of the value you create, the trust you cultivate, and the energy you align with. In this chapter, we will explore how to manifest financial abundance by shifting your money mindset, aligning with the flow of wealth, and taking intentional action. What beliefs or patterns might be holding you back from unlocking your treasure chest? How can you cultivate a healthier, more empowered relationship with money? The chest is already overflowing. Are you ready to claim its riches? Financial prosperity is more than a number in a bank account or the possessions you acquire. It is an energy, a reflection of your inner alignment with abundance and your ability to create and manage wealth. Just as the treasure chest overflows when opened, financial abundance flows freely when your mindset, habits, and actions align with its principles. Unlocking this treasure requires examining your beliefs about money, embracing its flow, and acting with intention and trust. At the heart of financial abundance lies your money mindset. Your beliefs about wealth, often formed in childhood or shaped by societal influences, create the framework for how you relate to money. If you've internalized messages like, "money is the root of all evil," or "there's never enough," these beliefs act as blocks, limiting your ability to attract and sustain wealth. Reflect on your earliest memories of money. What lessons or emotions did you associate with it, and how might they still influence you today? Shifting your money mindset begins with reframing these beliefs into empowering ones. Money, at its core, is neutral, neither good nor bad, but a tool for exchange and a reflection of value. By viewing money as an energy that flows to and from you in alignment with your intentions, you can transform fear or resistance into trust and empowerment. For example, replacing "I'm not good with money" with "I am learning to manage money wisely" opens the door to growth. What new beliefs about money can you adopt to create a healthier relationship with wealth? Gratitude is a powerful force in attracting financial abundance. When you appreciate the resources you already have, no matter how modest, they become a foundation for greater wealth. Gratitude shifts your focus from lack to sufficiency, creating a vibration that aligns with prosperity. Take a moment to reflect on the money that has supported you. The meals it has bought, the opportunities it has provided, the experiences it has enabled. How can practicing gratitude for your current financial state enhance your connection to abundance? The flow of wealth depends on balance between giving and receiving, saving and spending, work and rest. Just as the treasure chest must be opened to reveal its riches, financial abundance grows when money flows freely and intentionally. Hoarding wealth out of fear creates stagnation, while reckless spending can deplete your resources. Instead, strive for stewardship. Using money wisely, sharing it generously, and allowing it to circulate in ways that align with your values. What practices can help you cultivate this balanced approach to wealth? Intentionality is key in managing and growing your finances. Setting clear financial goals, creating budgets, and tracking expenses are practical steps that reflect your commitment to financial abundance. These actions not only give you control over your resources but also signal to the universe that you are ready to handle greater wealth. Imagine a gardener tending a thriving garden, each plant representing a different financial goal: saving, investing, giving, or enjoying. How can you cultivate your financial garden with care and intention? Manifesting financial abundance also involves aligning with opportunities. Opportunities often come disguised as risks or challenges, requiring you to step outside your comfort zone. Whether it's starting a new venture, asking for a raise, or exploring an investment, acting with courage and trust allows you to expand your wealth in ways that align with your goals. What opportunities might you be overlooking due to fear or hesitation, and how can you embrace them with confidence? Generosity is a cornerstone of financial prosperity. Giving, whether through charity, acts of kindness, or supporting loved ones, reinforces the flow of wealth and strengthens your connection to abundance. Generosity is not about giving beyond your means. It is about sharing from a place of trust, knowing that what you give returns to you multiplied. How might practicing generosity in small, meaningful ways enhance your sense of wealth and fulfillment? Visualization can help align your energy with financial abundance. Close your eyes and picture the treasure chest overflowing with gold coins and jewels. See yourself opening it, its contents glowing with warmth and light. Imagine using this treasure to achieve your financial goals, support others, and create the life you desire. Feel the gratitude and trust that accompany this vision, knowing that the chest reflects the wealth already present within you. How does this visualization inspire your approach to financial prosperity? Financial abundance also requires resilience. Setbacks, unexpected expenses, or economic shifts can challenge your confidence, but they also offer opportunities for growth. Just as a storm may scatter coins from the treasure chest, it also reveals new opportunities to secure and protect your wealth. Resilience involves learning from these experiences, adapting to changes, and maintaining your trust in the flow of abundance. What lessons have past financial challenges taught you, and how can they guide your future? Unlocking the treasure chest of financial prosperity is not about acquiring wealth for its own sake, but about aligning with its energy and purpose. It is about creating a life where money supports your values, enhances your experiences, and enables you to give and grow. What steps will you take today to shift your mindset, embrace the flow, and manage your resources with intention? The treasure chest is within you, its riches waiting to be revealed. Are you ready to open it and let its abundance flow? As you stand before the treasure chest in your mind, its lid slightly ajar, consider the beliefs and habits that shape your current relationship with wealth. Are they helping the chest to overflow, or are they keeping its lid closed? What shifts in your mindset or actions could allow its riches to flow more freely? Imagine yourself opening the chest, its golden contents spilling out in radiant abundance. Feel the warmth of gratitude for what you already have, and the excitement for the opportunities yet to come. What does this treasure represent for you, not just in terms of financial gain, but in the freedom, security, and generosity it allows? How can you align your thoughts, emotions, and actions with this vision? The treasure chest is a reminder that financial prosperity is not about chasing wealth, but about stewarding it wisely, sharing it generously, and trusting in its flow. What steps will you take today to unlock its potential and allow it to support the life you desire? The chest is overflowing, its energy ready to circulate. How will you use its treasures to create, give, and grow? Chapter 8. Abundance in Relationships. Picture a majestic tree standing tall in a serene meadow. Its branches stretch outward and upward, intertwining with other trees nearby, creating a canopy of connection and mutual support. Beneath its shade, life thrives, birds find refuge, animals rest, and humans gather. This tree, with its strong roots and interconnected branches, symbolizes the abundance found in relationships. Abundance in relationships is not merely about the number of connections you have. It is about their depth, authenticity, and the energy they bring into your life. Like the tree, relationships grow when nurtured with care, attention, and understanding. They require strong roots of trust and shared values, branches that reach toward mutual growth, and space to flourish without suffocation. In this chapter, we will explore how to cultivate abundance in your relationships, whether with family, friends, colleagues, or romantic partners. How can you strengthen the roots of trust, nurture the branches of connection, and celebrate the fruits of love and support? The tree is ready to grow. Are you prepared to nurture it? Abundant relationships are not built on superficial connections, but on a foundation of trust, respect, and mutual growth. Like the tree with intertwined branches, these relationships provide support and nourishment, creating a canopy of abundance that enriches everyone involved. Cultivating such connections requires intentionality, self-awareness, and a willingness to invest in both giving and receiving. At the heart of abundant relationships is trust. Trust forms the roots that anchor a relationship, providing stability and strength even in turbulent times. Trust is not just about honesty. It is about consistency, reliability, and a willingness to be vulnerable. Building trust requires open communication, respect for boundaries, and the courage to show your authentic self. Reflect on the relationships in your life. Where do you feel deeply rooted in trust, and where might these roots need more care? Vulnerability is a key element in fostering trust and connection. It allows you to share your true thoughts, feelings, and experiences without fear of judgment. Vulnerability can feel risky, but it creates a space for genuine understanding and intimacy. Consider a relationship where you've hesitated to be fully open. How might embracing vulnerability deepen your connection and invite greater abundance into this bond? Abundant relationships also thrive on mutual growth. Like the branches of a tree reaching toward the sky, these connections inspire both individuals to stretch beyond their comfort zones and support each other's evolution. Mutual growth does not mean identical paths, but a shared commitment to encouraging and celebrating each other's progress. How do your relationships support your growth, and how do you contribute to the growth of others? Communication is the sunlight that nourishes relationships. Clear, honest, and empathetic communication ensures that misunderstandings are resolved, needs are expressed, and connections remain vibrant. Active listening, truly hearing and understanding another person, strengthens bonds and fosters empathy. How might improving your communication skills enhance the abundance in your relationships? Generosity is another cornerstone of abundant relationships. This generosity is not limited to material gifts. It includes the gift of time, attention, and emotional presence. Small acts of kindness, like offering encouragement or simply being there for someone, ripple outward, deepening the connection. What opportunities do you have to show generosity in your relationships, and how might these actions strengthen your bonds? Healthy boundaries are essential for relationships to flourish. Just as a tree needs space to grow without being overshadowed by others, individuals need room to maintain their own identity and well-being. Setting boundaries is not about creating distance but about ensuring that relationships remain balanced and respectful. Are there relationships in your life where boundaries need to be established or adjusted, and how might this contribute to their health? Abundant relationships also require the ability to navigate conflict constructively. Disagreements are natural in any connection, but how they are handled can either strengthen or weaken the bond. Approaching conflict with empathy, a willingness to understand the other person's perspective, and a focus on resolution rather than blame transforms challenges into opportunities for growth. What conflicts in your relationships could be resolved with a shift in approach or mindset? Gratitude amplifies the abundance in relationships, just as it does in other areas of life. Expressing appreciation for the people in your life strengthens your bonds and invites more positive energy into your connections. A simple thank you or acknowledgement of someone's effort can make a profound difference. Who in your life deserves your gratitude today, and how might expressing it deepen your relationship? Relationships, like trees, require ongoing care. Regular check-ins, quality time, and acts of love and support are the water and nutrients that keep them alive. Neglect can lead to withering, while consistent attention allows connections to thrive. What practices can you adopt to nurture your relationships more intentionally and ensure they remain abundant? Finally, abundant relationships extend beyond one-on-one connections to the broader community. Just as a forest of interconnected trees creates an ecosystem of life and support, building strong relationships within your community fosters a network of abundance that benefits everyone. How can you contribute to a culture of connection and support within your community, amplifying abundance for all? Cultivating abundance in relationships is a lifelong practice of growth, generosity, and gratitude. By strengthening the roots of trust, nurturing the branches of connection, and tending to the needs of your relationships, you create bonds that enrich your life and the lives of others. What steps can you take today to invest in the relationships that matter most to you? The tree is growing, its branches intertwining. How will you continue to nurture it and let its abundance flourish? As you reflect on the tree with its intertwined branches, consider the relationships that form the canopy of your life. Which connections feel strong and vibrant, and which might need more care to grow? How might you deepen your roots of trust and strengthen the bonds that sustain you? Picture yourself standing beneath this tree, its branches providing shade and support, its roots anchoring it firmly in the ground. What small acts of care, expressing gratitude, offering kindness, or setting healthy boundaries, could nourish your relationships and help them flourish? What steps can you take to be a more present, generous, and authentic part of this network of connection? The tree of relationships is a reflection of your capacity to give and receive love, support, and understanding. How will you continue to tend to its growth, ensuring that it remains a source of abundance in your life and the lives of those around you? The branches are reaching, the roots are spreading. How will you honor the beauty of this interconnected canopy? As we near the conclusion, if you've been enjoying the audiobook, make sure to hit like and subscribe. Drop a comment below and share your biggest takeaway. Chapter 9. Vitality and Health. Picture a radiant sun rising over a vast, green field. Its golden light touches every blade of grass, energizing the soil, the plants, and the creatures it nourishes. This field is alive, thriving with vitality and balance, a testament to the harmony of nature. The sun represents the life force that fuels growth and sustains health, its steady presence an endless source of energy and renewal. Your body, mind, and spirit are much like this field. When cared for and aligned, they flourish, creating a foundation for vitality and well-being. Just as the field relies on sunlight, rain, and fertile soil, your health depends on balance in nourishment, movement, rest, and mindset. Vitality is not simply the absence of illness. It is the presence of energy, resilience, and alignment with your true self. In this chapter, we will explore how to cultivate abundant health and vitality in every area of your life. How can you create harmony between your physical, mental, and spiritual well-being? What practices will help you tap into your inner radiance and let it shine? The sun is rising, its light illuminating the field. Are you ready to let its energy guide you toward vibrant health? Vitality is the foundation of an abundant life, a reflection of harmony within your body, mind, and spirit. It is the energy that fuels your actions, the resilience that carries you through challenges, and the alignment that connects you to your higher purpose. Cultivating vitality requires intentional care, much like tending to a lush field beneath the nourishing light of the sun. This care begins with recognizing that health is not merely the absence of disease but the presence of balance, strength, and joy. The physical body is your anchor in the world, and its well-being is essential to vitality. Nourishment is the first pillar of physical health. Just as the field requires nutrient-rich soil, your body thrives on wholesome, balanced foods that provide energy and repair. Consider the choices you make each day. Are the foods you consume enhancing your vitality or depleting it? What shifts could you make to nourish your body more intentionally? Movement is the second pillar, akin to the breeze that circulates through the field, keeping it vibrant and alive. Exercise is not just about fitness. It is about fostering a flow of energy that sustains your body's systems. Regular movement improves circulation, supports mental clarity, and strengthens your connection to your physical self. Whether it's a morning walk, yoga, or dancing, finding joyful ways to move can transform your energy. How might incorporating regular, enjoyable movement enhance your vitality? Rest is the third pillar, reflecting the cycles of night that allow the field to rejuvenate. Sleep is when the body repairs, the mind processes, and the spirit restores. Chronic stress and overwork disrupt these rhythms, depleting energy and creating imbalance. Creating a ritual for rest, whether through sleep hygiene, relaxation techniques, or moments of stillness, helps reset your systems. Are you giving yourself enough time to rest and recover, and how can you create a sanctuary for renewal? Mental well-being is equally important in cultivating vitality. The thoughts you think and the beliefs you hold shape the energy you bring into your life. Negative patterns, such as self-doubt, fear, or criticism, act like weeds in the field, crowding out the growth of positive energy. Replacing these patterns with affirming thoughts and cultivating a mindset of gratitude and optimism creates fertile ground for well-being. What mental weeds might be holding you back, and how can you begin to replace them with thoughts that nourish your vitality? Emotional health is intertwined with mental clarity, and it thrives on the expression and processing of feelings. Suppressed emotions, like stagnant water in a field, create blockages that disrupt the flow of energy. Practices such as journaling, therapy, or mindfulness help release these blockages, allowing emotional energy to flow freely. How might processing and expressing your emotions contribute to greater harmony and vitality in your life? Spiritual alignment is the sunlight that illuminates the field, connecting you to your higher self and the greater flow of the universe. Whether through meditation, prayer, or time spent in nature, spiritual practices help you tap into a deeper well of energy and purpose. This connection brings clarity, peace, and a sense of belonging, enriching every area of your health. What practices help you feel most connected to your spirit, and how can you prioritize them in your life? Community and relationships also play a role in your vitality, much like the ecosystem of a field where every element supports the whole. Supportive connections provide encouragement, love, and a sense of belonging, while toxic relationships drain energy and disrupt balance. Surrounding yourself with people who uplift and inspire you enhances your health and resilience. Who in your life contributes positively to your vitality, and how can you nurture these connections? Gratitude amplifies the energy of vitality, much like sunlight strengthening the plants in a field. By appreciating your body, your experiences, and the health you currently have, you align yourself with abundance. Gratitude is not only for what is going well but also for the challenges that teach you resilience and growth. How can practicing gratitude for your health, even in small ways, enhance your connection to vitality? Finally, cultivating vitality involves honoring the unique rhythms of your body and life. Just as the field requires different care in each season, your needs will change over time. Listening to your body, adapting to its signals, and being gentle with yourself during transitions are essential for sustained well-being. Are there areas in your life where you might need to adjust your approach to health, and how can you honor these shifts with grace? Vitality is not a destination but a practice of alignment, care, and presence. By tending to your physical, mental, emotional, and spiritual health, you create a foundation for abundance that radiates through every aspect of your life. What steps can you take today to nourish your vitality, and how will these actions transform your energy and well-being? The field is thriving, the sun is shining. How will you cultivate this harmony and let your health flourish? As you envision the radiant sun illuminating the lush field, take a moment to reflect on the harmony within your own life. Are there areas where your physical, mental, emotional, or spiritual well-being might need more care and attention? What steps can you take to bring these aspects into greater balance, ensuring that your vitality thrives? Picture yourself standing in the field, feeling the warmth of the sun on your skin, the energy of the earth beneath your feet. Let this image remind you of the interconnectedness of your health, the nourishment of your body, the clarity of your mind, the flow of your emotions, and the light of your spirit. How can you honor this connection each day, creating a foundation for lasting well-being? Vitality is a reflection of the care and intention you bring to your life. What small, consistent actions can you take to nurture your energy and align with the flow of abundance? The sun is always rising, its light ready to guide you. How will you let it illuminate your path to health and harmony? The field is thriving, and so are you. How will you continue to let your vitality grow? Conclusion: Living the abundant life. Imagine a fountain in the heart of a serene garden, its waters cascading endlessly, clear and vibrant. The fountain is self-sustaining, its source infinite, its flow unbroken. Each drop contributes to the pool below, creating ripples that extend outward, touching everything they meet. This fountain symbolizes the essence of abundance, not a finite resource to be hoarded, but an ever-renewing flow to be embraced and shared. Living an abundant life is not about accumulation or achieving a single, fixed state of success. It is about alignment, aligning your thoughts, emotions, and actions with the universal energy of abundance. It is about recognizing that abundance exists not only in wealth, but in love, health, creativity, and connection. Like the fountain, Your life can overflow with blessings when you allow abundance to flow freely, trusting in its infinite source. This conclusion reflects on the journey of manifesting abundance in all areas of life, emphasizing the principles of alignment, trust, and intentional action. What have you learned about the flow of abundance within and around you, and how will you carry these lessons forward? The fountain is flowing, its energy infinite. How will you let it inspire the life you create? Abundance is not a destination but a way of being, a practice of alignment, trust, and intentional living. Throughout this journey, we've explored the principles that allow abundance to flourish. Planting the seeds of intention, clearing the soil of limiting beliefs, nurturing growth with gratitude, and aligning with the flow of receiving, vitality, and connection. Together, these practices create a life that overflows with richness in every dimension. At the heart of abundance is the understanding that it begins within. Your thoughts, emotions, and beliefs shape the energy you emit, influencing the flow of blessings into your life. When you cultivate a mindset of possibility, gratitude, and trust, you align yourself with the frequency of abundance, becoming a magnet for opportunities and growth. What shifts in your inner world have you made during this journey, and how have they transformed your experience of abundance? Abundance is also about balance, the delicate harmony between giving and receiving, effort and rest, ambition and contentment. Like the fountain that replenishes itself, balance ensures that your energy remains sustainable, allowing you to give generously without depleting yourself. How might you create greater balance in your life, ensuring that you remain open to receiving while contributing to the world around you? Living abundantly requires trust. Trust in the timing of growth, in the universe's provision, and in your own ability to navigate life's changes. Challenges and setbacks are not signs of lack but opportunities for growth and alignment. Each obstacle you've faced has likely brought you closer to your truth, teaching you resilience and sharpening your clarity. How can you honor these experiences as essential parts of your journey toward abundance? Gratitude amplifies abundance, transforming what you have into more than enough. By appreciating your current blessings, you create space for more to flow into your life. This gratitude extends beyond material wealth to the love, health, and creativity that enrich your days. What are you most grateful for at this moment, and how can this practice of gratitude become a cornerstone of your abundant life? Abundance is not meant to be hoarded, it is meant to be shared. Like the fountain that nourishes the garden around it, your abundance creates ripples that touch others. Acts of generosity, whether offering time, resources, or kindness, magnify the flow of abundance for everyone. How might you use the blessings in your life to uplift and inspire others, creating a ripple effect of positivity and growth? Your journey through abundance is ongoing, a dynamic relationship with the energy of creation. There will be times when the flow feels slow or interrupted, but these moments invite you to realign and reconnect with your inner fountain. By returning to the principles you've cultivated, intention, trust, gratitude, and balance, you can restore the flow and step back into harmony. What practices will you commit to maintaining, ensuring that abundance remains a central part of your life? Abundance is not a finite resource but an infinite energy that grows as you align with it. It is the trust in life's capacity to provide, the joy of sharing your blessings, and the peace of knowing that you are supported by an endless source. How will you carry this understanding forward, allowing it to shape the choices you make, the relationships you build, and the dreams you pursue? The fountain flows, its ripples expanding. How will you let it guide your path? As you reflect on this journey, consider the vision of abundance you hold for your life. What does it look like, feel like, and mean to you? How will you embody this vision, bringing it to life in your thoughts, actions, and relationships? Abundance is already within you, ready to flow. How will you honor its presence and let it transform your journey? As you stand before the flowing fountain, its waters clear and endless, take a moment to consider the journey you've undertaken. What truths about abundance have been revealed to you, and how have they shaped your understanding of yourself and the world around you? How has this exploration deepened your trust in the flow of life and your own capacity to create and receive? Imagine the fountain as a reflection of your inner abundance, its flow sustained by your thoughts, emotions, and actions. Feel its energy radiating outward, touching every aspect of your life, your relationships, health, creativity, and sense of purpose. How can you nurture this flow, ensuring that it remains vibrant and harmonious, no matter the challenges you face? The fountain is also a reminder of your ability to share abundance, creating ripples that extend far beyond yourself. As you walk forward, how will you use your blessings to inspire and uplift others? What acts of kindness, generosity, or connection will reflect the overflow of abundance in your life? Abundance is not something to be achieved, but something to be lived. It is the ongoing practice of alignment, trust, and gratitude that allows your life to flourish like the garden surrounding the fountain. What commitments will you make to continue nurturing this flow, ensuring that it grows stronger and more radiant with each passing day? The fountain is infinite, its source unending, its energy yours to embrace. How will you let its flow guide you as you move forward, creating a life rich with meaning, connection, and joy? The fountain flows endlessly. How will you honor its presence and let its ripples shape the abundant life you are ready to live?